Hello, I'm Mr. R. Midger, a retired lecturer in metallurgy, preaching Christianity and Sikhism. I'm going to Kitchen Talk tomorrow in Hamburg, and I've prepared a one-page placard or a poster, you know, that I will take with me and hope to put it in some of the places. And I thought I should give the introduction to that one, so that if you are interested, you too can print them. And after printing, you can also paste or post it, you know, in prominent places. So people should know that in Jesus we are being set free, solitary, and all the Antichrist are dominating today with dog collars and other things. Here is the text, you know. My elder brother Christ Thomas said, remember that our elder brother Christ Jesus is anointed one, and the other twin brothers of Jesus that they became at Pentecost when they were paid their wage of Holy Spirit, they were just Christ, not anointed one. So my elder brother Christ Thomas said, why should I fast? What sin have I committed? And why should I pray? What wrong have I done? Now these people, you know, old ritual, they were in the old brick-built temple. And this sin, fasting and prayer is for the disciples of the rabbis to discipline them. And their God is Yahweh, the demiurge God. And the rabbi kept the people alienated from Yahweh. Only they were the authority on behalf of the Yahweh. All temple rituals of prayer, fasting, animal sacrifice, etc., are gone with the old temples made by human hands. So these were synagogues and other things made by human hands, and they had priests in them installed, rabbi. They are gone. Jesus gave his own sacrifice to move us from the old to the new temple, built not by human hands, but by nature, the most beautiful temple of God, for his brethren, the royal priest. We are the sons of the Most High royal priest, and we have been moved to the new house, which is this one, built by nature. Temple of God. Royal priests, being solitary, are capable of entering into the royal vineyard of our royal father, where the true vine, Christ Jesus, has been planted by our father. And it is our aim to graft ourselves to this true vine for nourishment. So unless, you know, we eat the flesh of Jesus and we drink the blood of Christ, we have no part in him. So this true vine, we should get ourselves grafted so that we also can produce fruit as produced by Christ Jesus. We can become his wives. Any branch that is not grafted to this true vine withers away. So anyone has not grafted, it withers away. That means you should make effort to get yourself grafted to this true vine. Nobody can make effort on your behalf. And not these sugar-coated sermon delivered by these antichrists in the churches. Oh, this royal kingdom is for everyone. And everyone can have a gospel, which is nonsense. Gospel is to those who are predestined of our Father, who are solitary. How many solitary people you find in the world? Very few. We are no more slaves to the Antichrist priests and their sins, but to the righteousness of our own hearts. We are our own judge. We don't have anybody to judge us. Priests judge people that you have committed sin or not, the yardstick are the moral laws, and he is the schoolmaster who applies that yardstick. But we are not under the schoolmaster anymore, because we are not disciples that need disciplining. We are the laborers employed in the vineyard of our own Father. So we work hard because we are doing our own labor and for our own Father, not for somebody else. So those schoolmasters gone, and so their disciples and their sin and all that rituals. Antichrist, the hireling dog-collared priest, these priests that you find them in churches, they are not working for mammon, they are not working for God, but mammon. At the end of the service, which is 65, they get retirement. From whose service they get retired? From service of mammon, not from God. We don't get retirement from God unless our Father calls us. So they are hypocrite of the first degree. And you can see how many people can detect their hypocrisy. All stones sitting in the churches. And this Antichrist tell them pray, and they bend their heads down and they start praying earnestly. They are like widow's mite, and they are turning stones into bread. Simple-minded people. Antichrist, hireling dog-collared priest, found in churches, fulfill Matthew 12, verse 43 to 45. The parable of arid temple priest who were sacked by Jesus. They could not find any green pasture. They said, oh, let's go back to our old house. They came into the church of God by jumping over the walls with the Torah, rotten Torah under their armpit. And that poisoned the church. Apostle used to come and they told the apostle, look, they are reading Torah, they don't need your gospel, go away. And they appointed presbyters, and then the people say, hey, we need Christ. And when they say need Christ, they made a statue of Christ there. Here you are, Christ, and statue of Mary, and all that, you know, saints, Paul even. If Paul comes into such a church to find his own statue, how happy he would be. So this is the situation. Christianity is not for the dead. Our Father is living, and the Christianity of our living anointed elder brother Christ Jesus is for the living in spirit people who are twice born, and not for the once born. In Jesus we have the fellowship of royal priest, in which everyone gives his own account to God. That is, unless a female becomes a male, she cannot enter into the royal kingdom of God, the royal vineyard of our Father. Now a female is one, not in flesh, because when Jesus is talking, he's talking in spiritual sense, not in moral sense at all, because that is not his regime. He comes from the supernatural Father, so his preaching is in spirit, that applies to men and not to the other thing, you know, not to the physical body, which is to our mind, soul, not to our physical body. Physical body has male and female in genitals. But he is not talking about these male and female. In spirit, a person is a female if he does what somebody else tell him to do. That is, he is a disciple of anyone, of a bishop, pope, or anyone. Pope has so many females. They do what Pope tells them to do. They are all female. So they cannot be fished into the royal kingdom of God. A male is a person who is a master of his own destiny. Whether in flesh, the person is a woman or a man. But in spirit, he is a male if he or she is the master of his or her own destiny. Like John 9, the born blind person. That was the typical example Jesus said, that I have come to fish such people, fishers of men and not of women. She cannot enter into the royal kingdom of God, the royal vineyard of our Father. Because the enter that vineyard is a narrow gate that is for solitary, not two person can pass. So you need to be solitary. We renew. Thus we renew our inner man, the Christ, every day. And we are the fishers of men and not of women. So it's quite interesting, and I have tried to put the whole thing in a nutshell, and hope you will enjoy it. I have put up over 2,850 YouTube videos. Channel is neither one. So if you are interested, you can go and watch my videos. But you have to learn the things from basics yourself. And I have tried to give you the guidance, but guidance is only useful if you are interested in learning gospel. Nobody can learn gospel by some pieces here, some pieces there. Gospel is like a jigsaw puzzle. You have to understand where the pieces go. That only you can understand when you learn things from basics going up. So it is your effort that will bear fruit. So I have also learned it with my own effort. I haven't read any books, and I don't go by any book. We lead the Bible, and the Bible does not lead us. We get the information that we want, and then we know what is the real thing. The Bible is corruptible. Anything that is written is corruptible. So you have to think logically and get the true logo from our Father through logical reasoning. Hope you will be printing this poster and posting it around so that the other people can also know about these facts, and if they are interested, they will go to my YouTube. So nobody is perfect. We all learn. Only for people who are perfect, they are the one who have received the Holy Spirit with capital S, as these laborers of Jesus, 12 laborers of Jesus, they received it at Pentecost from the fourth man, Christ Jesus. So, if you call Jesus a Lord or God a Lord, you become slaves. If you become slave, you are not allowed into the vineyard. You are kept outside. Vineyard is for only for the sons of our Father. And sons can enter into and out of the vineyard without any problem. Even they sit at the table with our Father. But the slaves can't. Slaves are kept outside the house. And they can't sit on the same table as our Father. So with this note, I will say God bless you and hope we get something out of this Kirchentag, which is taking place in Hamburg, Germany, from 1st May to 5th May of this year.